pick a few questions from the media. When I say your name, please make your way to the boom mic, and we'll begin with Robert Fife of CTV News.
Mr. Harper, the rise of the NDP seems to have caught everybody by surprise, including your own party. You've now started to run attack ads, and you're heading to a Tory riding on the West Coast to play defense. You might lose that seat. Do you run the risk of turning off voters if you go too hard on Smiling Jack? And are you afraid that your majority is now at risk?
Mr. Harper, please, can you answer this in French and English? You're not really answering this question as to what extent are you surprised by the NDP surge in Canada and in Quebec? And does this change your plans? For instance, we're going to BC today, where you might lose seats to the NDP. Will the next few days be spent by you in ridings that you might lose? I've said repeatedly that I'm not a campaign analyst.
Thank you. Sir, you have been portraying yourself in this campaign throughout as tough on crime and a friend to victims, and I'd like to put to you, if you don't mind, some items which suggest to your critics otherwise, and to have your comments on these in both languages, if you could. First, your candidate in Scarborough, we all now know, was an enthusiastic cheerleader for a terrorist group, the Tamil Tigers. Now that one of your own ministers, Peter Kent, has repudiated him, you haven't. Why not? Why is Mr. Paranchotti still your candidate? And second, you promised in your 2006 platform, Stand Up for Canada, to create a national security commissioner. You broke that promise, and you continue to break it even when a judge that you appointed, John Major, urged you to keep it, said it was essential and would require no new bureaucracy. So the second question is why you broke your promise on such a basic issue of public safety. And finally, your campaign has now issued what seems to be a completely preposterous statement on the decision of your candidate in Vancouver South, Wei Young, to meet with and receive the endorsement of a well-known member, founder member of the Baba Khalsa terrorist group, who paid over $100,000 to the bomb maker in Air India. And, sir, the point here is that Malik was front-page news for five straight years in the biggest criminal case in Canadian history in her town. And Wei Young now claims, oh, she didn't know who he was, went to his meeting, heard him endorse her, didn't know who she was. Isn't that a slap in the face to the Air India victims' families? And why is Wei Young still your candidate?
First of all, in all three of these things, so first of all, our candidate in Scarborough has been very clear on his rejection of the Tamil Tigers. Very clear on that. That is the position of this party, and this party is the one that listed the Tamil Tiger organization. In terms of the National Security Commissioner, we looked at that some years ago, concluded that the current arrangement where we have a national security advisor coordinating a number of agencies within the Privy Council office is the way we want it to go. I think that is the most effective way to go, and we've looked at the various other options. Finally, in terms of the candidate in Vancouver South, she was invited to attend a school. She attended in good faith. She has been very clear. She and her campaign have no links and do not welcome in any way Mr. Malik into this party. We're absolutely clear about that.
You absolutely believe so.